In this video, I'm going to show you what product variants and additional options are and how to add variants and options to products in your online store. I've created a website with products that have variants and additional options. Variants are products that differ from each other by an attribute. For example, by color. One product can have several attributes. In my example, the product variants differ from each other by color and size. To switch the variant, website visitors can select another value using color and size drop-down lists. If you sell the same product in different colors, you can add photos for each variant of the product. When variants are switched, photos will automatically change. The customer will be able to see what different variants look like. Besides, you can specify a separate SKU and a separate price for the variant, if the variants of different colors also differ in price. Now let's have a look at additional options. Additional options are common for all product variants. For example, I have added the built-in electronics option, and this option is valid for all the product variants. If you select the option, its cost is added to the total price of the selected product. Now let's figure out how to set up the variants and additional options. First, let's have a look at the variants. For this tutorial, I've created a separate project. Edit the page containing a block with product cards from the store category. Connected the catalog by clicking the product catalog in the content tab. And then get started with product catalog. Now let me delete the default products and add my own ones. To do that, I click the Add Product button, enter the title of the product, and click the Add Product button. The next step is to upload the product photos and photos of the variants. I click the Upload Files button, select the images, and then click Upload Selected. To add the variants of the product, go to the Product Variants tab. Click Add New Option. Enter the option title in the title field. I'll add the color, for example, and then click the Add button. To add other options, I repeat these steps. For each variant, you can add a separate image, either by selecting the image from those you've uploaded before, or by uploading new ones. Also, you can create a separate SKU, price, quantity, and title for each variant. Note that dimensions, weight, and the external ID are also customizable. Let me add other variants. To do that, I click Add a new variant and modify the fields for each variant. Note that if you add several options, for example, both color and size, you should add all their possible combinations. I've added all sizes for each color here. You can specify the quantity available for sale for each variant separately, or leave this field empty, then the quantity will be unlimited. To complete the product setup, click Save and Close. Now I'll repeat the actions and add other products. To view the added variants of the products that are listed in the catalog, you can click the plus option. For your convenience, you can also edit the price and quantity of the variants right here in this list. To do that, click the price value and edit it. The same is true for the quantity value. I've added the variants to the catalog. Now I want to display the products on the page. To do that, I go to the page editor, open the content tab of the block with the products, and under Show Products from the catalog, select All Products. Now I publish the page and check what the customers are going to see. In the product pop-up, you can see the added variants with various attributes. When I switch the attributes, I can see the variants. The product SKU, price, and photo change accordingly. Now let me show you how to add extra options to the product. To do that, let me open the product catalog. Here I click on the product and scroll down to the Additional Options tab. I can specify the name and values for each option. My option is called built-in electronics. It has three option values: no electronics, phone charger, and cup warmer. If the option has its price, you should specify equal and plus signs and the price, only figures without a currency sign. This way, if a customer chooses an additional option, its price will be added automatically. To complete the option setup, I click Save and Close. Now let me go back to the page and refresh it. You can see that in the product pop-up, additional options is now available. As you can see, by default, the first option in the list is displayed, and it doesn't have any extra cost, so the total price of the product has not changed. If I select other options, the total price changes. Note that if the first option comes with an extra cost, suppose we have this option first, it will be displayed by default in the product pop-up. So the option price always gets added to the total product price. If you have any questions, I recommend you check out our help center, which gets updated regularly. Thanks for watching and good luck with creating wonderful websites. Bye!